What is up, guys? I cry for spilt milk here, and here is my F1 2020 mid-season sort of review, sort of how things are going, that sort of thing. But before I get into it, I just want to pay my personal tribute to Patrick Head, Claire, and Frank Williams for the contribution they made to this fantastic sport ever since they joined in 1977. It's going to be absolutely tragic not to see, perhaps not see them on the grid again. You know, the Italian Grand Prix was their last outing with the team. You know, they've given so much to the sport. They've made drivers like Kiki Rosberg, Nigel Mansell, Alan Jones, Damon Hill, Jack Villeneuve, world champions. They've also given debuts to drivers like Nico Rosberg, Jenson Button, Juan Pablo Montoya, David Coulthard, and a few more besides. They're giving these drivers their chances to the first chance on the grid to really show what they can really do. It wasn't for you know, the three guys, you know, Patrick Head, Frank Williams, and Claire Williams deciding to give these drivers a go, they might not become world champions. Nico Rosberg's and Jenson Button's case. And Jack Villeneuve as well. You know, he was a. That was a team. He's Williams was Jack Villeneuve's first team, and he became world champion at a second attempt with the team. So just wanted to start the video with that. So we've had just had the Italian Grand Prix, as I just mentioned. And wow, we had such a feel good story of Pierre Gasly winning the race. What a race! What a Grand Prix that was. Exciting from flag to finish, you know, from first flag, second flag to finish. I just wish all Grand Prix were like that, you know, halfway through, they just stop the race as it is and then just start it again, bunch the field up again. That would be really exciting if they did that every race. I'm not really keen on this reverse grid idea. It's not, the sport's just not pure with that idea. It's just, you know, it should always should be like, you know, the fastest team should win and come to the top. Although it doesn't make for exciting racing for the top spot. I mean, you know, in this age, it's Mercedes and Red Bull leading the way, but you've got an exciting midfield scrap between, say, you know, McLaren, Renault, AlphaTauri's joining in that scrap as well, and also Racing Point. So we've gone for one of the perhaps best feel-good stories of recent times in Formula 1 with Pierre Gasly winning the Italian Grand Prix. And then now we've got a gut-wrenching, cruel story of Sergio Perez being shafted at Racing Point, which will be rebranded as Aston Martin next season for Sebastian Vettel. Although, looking at this season, you know, Lance Stroll's had the better form, I think he's had the better results, better qualifying. Lance Stroll qualified third for the British Grand Prix, and then Nico Hülkenberg qualified third for the race after the 70th anniversary Grand Prix. I think it's been a really cruel decision. It was thanks to Sergio Perez that allowed the consortium to take control of the team. So I bet it's really, Sergio Perez is feeling really hard done by, and I do feel his frustration. I know he's come out on social media saying, you know, he's thanked the team and everyone else, and he's looking to the future. But I just think it's been really hard done by. You know, if you were, most people would agree, even though Lance Stroll had a better form this season, overall, throughout the careers of both drivers, Sergio Perez has been a better driver, being more consistent, and so on and so forth. So I think that's a real gut-wrenching decision for me. I'm really gutted that you know, when as soon as the Aston Martin team, Racing Point team becomes competitive, he's dropped. I think he's worthy of a second stab at a top team. Although he did join McLaren for his second or third season in the team. I don't McLaren at the time were just on their that's they were starting their downward spiral. Prior to their, you know, to their teaming up with Honda, so I think Sergio Perez was definitely worthy of a second shot at a top team. He might still get it, you know. There's still a seat going at Red Bull. You know, Sergio Perez, what a great driver! Any team would benefit from a driver such as Sergio Perez. is this rare breed of driver like Carlos Sainz, who not only is a fantastic driver in the car and out the car, he's also can bring you a budget as well. He's also got some financial backing with him as well. So it'd be a very attractive proposition for any team. I definitely think he'll be still in the sport though, with Haas or Alfa Romeo is most likely destination. Personally, I'd love to see him at Red Bull, have Albon and Gasly duking out at AlphaTauri to decide which one of them should be the next, you know, the next the supporting actor to Sebastian Vettel, Max Verstappen. Because I think they should give Perez a couple of seasons at Red Bull. By that time, he's getting old now, Sergio Perez. So probably a few seasons left, and then perhaps hopefully a team opportunity elsewhere might open up for Sergio Perez. But yeah, he's done it before though. He's rebuilt a team. It took a few seasons to get what was Force India to one of the top winning teams, and to attract drivers like Sebastian Vettel to come to the team. He's done really well to be part of that. Part of that process of rebuilding a team, so he can do it. He's the sort of driver that Alfa Romeo and Haas really need at the moment. I think Haas is most likely destination. I think just for Haas, I need a whole shake up of their entire team. But Grosjean's got to go this season. I'm really sorry. Neither driver's really shone this season. I don't think they've done very well at all. Neither has Alfa Romeo. They've been really poor as well. Even Ferrari, they've been really duking out with the back markers, so that's not where we want Ferrari to be. I'm sure Carlos Sainz is looking at his contract saying, is there some sort of get out clause, you know? I think Ricciardo would be really smiling seeing how McLaren are getting on. So I bet him is thinking, I'm glad that Sainz has gone to Ferrari so I can get this really good seat next season. So yeah, it's been a good season so far. Been really exciting, really different. It's going to be one that I'm going to remember for sure. We just completed the 8 races, so this was the mandatory 8 races we needed to. So at least we can, whatever happens with coronavirus now, if there's going to be a second spike, this counts as a full season. You know, we've had the 8 races now, so anything we get now is a bonus. It's really exciting. It's double headed at some circuits like at Portimao and Mugello, getting having their first ever race. I think it's really, I like this returning a tragedy into an opportunity. So it gives other circuits a chance to show the world what they can do, a new experience for everyone. So I'm really glad that we're getting these new experiences as well. This opportunity, we're taking opportunity, not just saying, oh, that's it, eight races, that's your lot. We've got the Turkish Grand Prix coming back as well, two rounds at Bahrain to finish off the season. I'm so looking forward to the season. I'm definitely going to get the, there's a book out, I do have a few of them myself, called the Grid or Grand Prix. I'm definitely going to get one for 2021 so I can remember this seat 2020 this season, and what's going on this season. So I think it's been a really good season. If you look past Mercedes dominating everything, if you look at the midfield fight, it's so exciting. You don't know who's going to finish third, even though more often than not that would be Max Verstappen. But looking past Max Verstappen and the two Mercedes, battle for fourth, it's intense. It could be any of the, the Racing Point drivers, or any of the Renault drivers, or McLaren drivers, even AlphaTauri, they're back, well back in this hunt after the latest result. That's how I think it's gone so far. It's going to be a really good season. Stroll's really turned the corner. I think it's due to this recent form. Lawrence Stroll, his father will argue, well, going into, we've had the 8 races this season and Lawrence Stroll's been the better driver. Oh, right, yeah, Sergio Perez has had 2 races out because of, catching the coronavirus. We've seen Nico Hülkenberg back for two races. Again, That's brilliant news, because to see Nico Hülkenberg have at least have a race this season, I think it's going to be. I hope it's going to be Perez and Hülkenberg at Haas next season, or I hope, or either way, I hope they're both back on the season. I think Raikkonen and Grosjean have got to go, so maybe Giovinazzi might go to partner Magnussen at Haas, and then both end up at Alfa Romeo. But that can't happen because one of the seats is a Ferrari Junior seat, so they'll probably not Hülkenberg will probably end up at Perez will end up at Haas, so it probably would be Magnussen perhaps going to Alfa Romeo to partner Giovinazzi. I think that's what Magnussen needs. He needs to try something else. It's he had a season at McLaren, was ditched. He was the one that actually replaced Perez at McLaren, and then he was ditched after a season as well. So, but yeah, you know, it's lucky for him that Pastor Maldonado's sponsorship dried up, so he got the seat at Renault and got back into the sport. I think that Kevin Magnussen's worthy of a spot in the sport. Grosjean is just dodgy. He's just like he's a dangerous driver as well. When people try to overtake him, he moves in the braking zone. I think it's been an exciting season so far. Lots going on. Really close midfield fight. I think Mercedes will walk this season though. But I think my prediction of Max Verstappen being world champion was a bit audacious and a bit, for me, hoping that Red Bull might steal a mark on Mercedes for the first few races, like Braun GP did in 2009. You know, Jens Bergman in the first six races, and then just holding on for the rest of the season just to secure the title. So I was hoping that might happen to Max Verstappen, especially during the shortened season. At the time, we only thought we were going to have eight races, so if he could win the first few, then he would be certainly in a good shout. Hopefully here's to the end of the 2020. Hope we're going to have an exciting end of the season and carry on from the Italian Grand Prix, where more feel-good stories, it's just really a gut-wrenching to hear that Sebastian Vettel's replaced Perez at Racing Point Aston Martin. But there we go. It is gut-wrenching to see. It's a real sharp pull out there from the one. I think going into the Tuscan Grand Prix, making that decision, I think Vettel and Stroll, Stroll's the best driver, score more points, qualify better. He's a driver in form at the moment, and that's how you've got to just make a decision. You've got to see who's in form. It's like Pierre Gasly going to Red Bull initially. He was in form, and then he lost that form, and Albon had a bit of form. So there's another story I want to talk about. Is I think Gasly should stay at AlphaTauri. He's doing really well there. There's not in the spotlight there to succeed. Like Albon, there's loads of people saying, we need to get Gasly back at Red Bull. I don't think that would be very helpful. I think that Red Bull's been built around Verstappen. So unless there's a driver who drives like Verstappen and so on and so forth, I think Red Bull, they've got to look at someone like Perez or Hülkenberg, to someone experienced to partner Verstappen. I think Albon and Gasly both need a few more seasons at AlphaTauri to find their craft and establish themselves as solid drivers, solid midfield runners at least. Whoever wins that battle should get the seat at Red Bull. Just give Hülkenberg or Perez a couple of seasons at Red Bull, and then see from there from Gasly and Albon who's better. So yeah, I think that's it for me at the moment. I probably will. Probably loads of things I've probably neglected to mention in this video, but I'll probably make a video for those later on. So that's here it goes. Covered a few things like some stories, recent stories. Also, Lewis Hamilton launching his own Formula E team, X44 Extreme team. So yeah, it's Lewis's. I think that's a good move for Lewis, because that's his. That's his team. That's what he believes. Believing in diversity and giving everyone a chance. I know that there's a rule in that competition where you've got one male and one female driver. So it's good to see. And I wonder who will drive for Lewis's team. Maybe Lewis might move to that team. He's not currently contracted for Mercedes next season, so I reckon he'll stay for another season just for the stats, or another season or two, just to show he's still the best. And then perhaps he'll go to set up team. Maybe that's like a project after Formula One that he'll do. Yep. So yeah, I think that I'm just blabbing on now. So I think I'm just going to end the video here and say thank you very much for watching. And please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting on my videos. Thank you.